Hello children, welcome back once again. Today we are going to read an interesting story, The Winter Oat, Unit 11 of your Gulmohar English Literature book. This story is written by Yuri Nagbin, who was popularly known by his full name Yuri Markovich Nagbin. He was born on 3rd April 1920. He was a Russian Soviet writer, screenwriter, and novelist. He was most famous for writing screenplays. He often wrote about war, childhood memories, and Russian history, among other things. He was died on 17th June 1994. Now, let's see the main characters of this story. The first main character of this story is Anna Vasilyevna. She is a young Russian school teacher who likes order and discipline. She is very serious about teaching, but judges very quickly. The next protagonist of this story is Savoshkin, who is always late to listen. The lateness and his behavior in class irritates Anna. He belongs to the world of nature. He is an observant, understanding, and a modest boy. The story starts when Anna Vasilyevna begins her lesson and greets the pupils. Her attitude towards the children is firm but respectful. There is a friendly atmosphere in the classroom. She begins her work immediately and has clearly grown in confidence as a teacher since last year when she was new and unsure of herself. Her voice is calm and seems to be enjoying her job. She realizes that one of her students, Savoshkin, is not in the room. When he walks in late, we see that her reaction is one of her disappointment rather than annoyance. His lateness reminds her to think of similar occasion when he has behaved in this way, and this in turn causes her to think of similar complaint she has had about the boy from the geography teacher. Anna Vasilyevna appears to be a critical of this older women's classroom discipline and the content of her lessons. Anna is quick to judge people and feels very self-assured about her own skill as a teacher. So that's all till paragraph number 7. In the next video, I will continue from the remaining paragraph. Till then, you have to see these keywords and learn it properly. The first word here is settlements. Settlement means places where people come to live, which were previously inhabited. The next word here is thought highly of, which means respected and admired someone. Then unison. Unison means speaking together at the same time. The next word is parts of speech. So parts of speech is a grammatical group such as nouns, pronouns, verbs, or adjective, etc., into which words are divided depending on how they are used. The next one is hush. Hush means silence. And the last word is blazing, which means very bright. Now students, you have to learn these keywords sincerely. In the next video, I will continue this chapter. Till then, take care. Bye-bye. Thank you so much.